night about a month ago in a little motel downtown. I was laying with lovely Linda when my wife kicked the door and tore it down. Linda screamed and grabbed the sheet, left me feeling like a crazy fool. A gun flew out of my wife's coat. I jumped up and cleared my throat. Did the only thing I knew to do. Buddy, I lied. This is not what it appears to be. This girl's with the CIA. She's working undercover here with me. We were just about to crack the case when you busted in and blew our disguise. Honey, that's the gospel truth. You can take my word or believe your lying eyes. Last night about 12 o'clock, sitting parked behind Kelsey's bar, I was holding Heavenly Helen when my wife drove up and caught us in Helen's car. I jumped out and raised the hood, walked around and kicked a tire or two. Helen grabbed her things and run. My wife grabbed for her old gun. I did the only thing I knew to do. Buddy, I lied. This is not what it appears to be. That girl's just a sales girl. She was trying to sell this used car to me. I was buying it for your birthday. Now you've gone and spoiled my surprise. Oh, honey, that's the gospel truth. You take my word or believe your lying eyes. Buddy, I lied. This is not what it appears to be. All right, smart Ellie. What would you have done if your wife had caught you in a girl's car? You'd have tore the door off. I jumped out, raised the hood, kicked tires. I mean, you know, I don't think she believed it, but it was something to do. Besides that, a moving target's harder to hit than one standing still. Yeah, who wants to die with a dumb look on their face? You know, I really don't know why I ever got myself in that position. Well, I know why I would do that.